playing that wonderful song. They did a really good job. While they're getting ready for the next act, I just want to thank you again for coming to our this year's annual multicultural show. And just a reminder that while people are performing, to just be respectful, like, keep your phones off, keep your voices down, or not tuning. Because we have a lot of wonderful performers, and I think that they deserve your full attention, so that would be great. Thank you. Well, while we're getting things ready, I can introduce the first act. To start off our show, we'd like to start our trip in here in America. We won't go that far, but just to New York, where hip-hop and freestyle of expression was created and developed in the late 70s. And here to share that creativity and culture is Treyon Gibbons.
Thank you.
rich cultural mix. Jamaica's influence extends far beyond its shores. The island is also known for its beauty, political stability, and plentiful resources. So please put your hands together for Yusuf Rajara. Mark and Senior Andreas and the students. Our next travels will take us across the Atlantic Ocean to East Africa. East Africa is a massive region of diverse cultures who all share the same heritage. There are as many as 100 different cultures that reside in that region, with dozens of languages spoken throughout that region, with very distinct views on their national identity. So please put your hands together for Sharon and Noreen.
Deaf and dumb to no reality. At a young age, I recognized, hey, blind as a fool, I remember in school I spent them pledging to my flag as I sit in science in the back of the class. The teacher goes with attendance and gets to Abdi. Not Abdurrahman, not Abdurrahim, or even Abdullahi, just Abdi. You should have seen the look on my face. She can't understand the language as she managed to call us slaves, but I was young in her face, so I chose not to be responsive. But then she gets to Muhammad. Then Muhammad, 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 no response, dead silence. But then she's reminded. Big Mo, Lil Mo, Tom Mo, Slow Mo, never flash nickname Mo, but we all know, and I'm thinking, what the, do you know? And she goes, I know it was your people that blew up the World Trade. So every time I see a tallah that prays the way you pray, I'm just reminded of that day. I'm not racist. All I am is afraid. Afraid. I see. So let me start with the apologies for those inhumane 19 so you don't constantly blame me. So stuck by that day makes it hard for me to speak, but had the noose around my neck, caught by the angry mob, lynch people like me, I'd have cried more publicly. But I've hidden my tears because I know freedom ain't free. Maybe I'm the one that needs to understand. I mean, what type of country will take the actions of a few and blame on a whole civilization? I mean, thank God we don't live in that nation. I mean, what type of nation would discriminate its people and justify them as an abomination? Nah. I live in the land of the free, where I can walk in bright and lighted streets as those around me hold on to what's dear, for I resemble fear, then taught to succeed with foundations that keep tumbling down. See, at school they teach us to be outspoken, but that's not what I'm showing. I fear for if I speak out, I'll be the next on the no-fly zone. That little cousin, he's on the same list, he's only 8 years old. He's probably a terrorist, I mean, what do I know? And this is only half of the problem. See, I feel for the brother named Muhammad, because only God gave him a job. History's turned the page, because the last time I checked, it was the black people that were slaves, locked up in chains, taught how to hate. But before they lose the American Indians, they got chased. But you're not American Indian. So you ain't gotta be afraid. And then it was the black people that got raped. But you're not black. So I guess you're okay. And then it was the Jewish people that got annihilated. But you're not Jewish. So you're okay. And now it's the Muslims that are slaves. But you're not Muslim. So what can you say? See, we fought for this country and still got condemned. Find us as marching with people who hated us, yet we managed to call them our friends. See, at first they would ask us questions like, if we went to war today, would you shoot us or shoot them? And such radical cults that you're thinking as a joke. But how long can a joke go before you start to think, is this the only thing they know? See, I found myself at an airport for a victim by a lot of this so-called